today we discuss the FX system. FX system is the building automation system. This is the system architecture. In FX system, it contains a server, and or a computer. The computer used to communicate between the controllers and computer. And in the system, it contains could contain many supervisory controllers. Each supervisory controller connect to many different field controllers. The field controllers are used to control the equipment or assistance in the building. And the supervisory controller is used to monitor the system operation. Also, this one is different components will communicate through the supervisory controller. Also, in the system, will contain many I/O module, input/output module, and also will contain many sensors, like the temperature sensor, pressure sensor, or occupancy sensor. Contains many sensors or I/O modules. The communication between the supervisory controller and the server or computer through the Ethernet cable. And the controller, supervisory controller, will connect with the field controllers with the FC bus. FC bus to use the cable like this, three wires or four wires cable connect in daisy chain. Daisy chain is from this controller connect in the FC bus terminal from this controller connect to PCG controller, and then from the PCG controller, FC bus connect to the next controller, FC bus, and then from this FC bus connect to next controllers, and next, and so on. Like here, the same. This supervisory controller connect with the field controllers with FC bus in daisy chain. And the input-output module, all the sensors is connected to each controller, field controller connect to SA bus. These modules, all sensors, input the signal to the controller. And this controller will output signal to control the equipment or assistant. And also, in this system, we will use a Bluetooth. This Bluetooth device is used for the communication between the computer to the field controllers. because this system, we need to do program for each controllers. These controllers control the system or equipment in the building. So we need to do program for each controller. And then we use the Bluetooth. Use the Bluetooth for the communication. Communication between the computer and the controllers. So we complete the program, and then download the program from the computer to the controllers. Here we have a smaller system in our lab. This is a computer station, and this is a supervisor controller. And we have these few controllers. These few controllers we use to control the some lighting system, or we use a PCB controller control the LED box. So these few controllers will control different system or equipment. The supervisory controller, is communicate with the few controllers and monitor the system operation. And this controller, supervisory controller, through the Ethernet cable, connect to the computer. So through the computer, you can monitor the system operation. Like the system we have here. This one is a supervisory controller. This is a PCG controller. We use this controller to control the lighting system. And this is a PCB controller. This PCB controller, we use it to control the VAB box. These controllers, they are connected through FC bus. This terminal, FC bus. Use this cable connect from this controller to here, to the supervisory controller. And then from the supervisory controller, same terminal, you connect to a PCG controller. And in this system, we have a thermostat. This is a thermostat. And occupancy sensor here. This one is a signal input to it connect to SA bus. Connect to SA bus here. So four wires connect to SA bus to here. And also we have a temperature sensor, RTD, this temperature sensor here, connect to here, input one here. Or you can connect to input two or input three, any input here. This is a universal input signal. Six input. You can connect to any port to here. But in the program, the points are different. This is a RTD's temperature sensor, and also we will use a Bluetooth device. connect to here, connect to here. We use computer to do programming. Once the program is complete, then we download the program to the controller through Bluetooth device. So these are the small system we have in our lab. This is the supervisory controller. Supervisory controller is used to monitor the whole system. The supervisory controller can connect to the computer. Through the computer, you can monitor the system, each controller, the working condition. For the supervisory controller installation, we need to see here the supervisory controller, each component. Here, these are indicators. These indicators indicate the connections here. Indicator connection here, like this one, LAN 1, LAN 2 here. We'll show you the LAN 1, LAN 2 here. This is an Ethernet connection. This is a primary. This is a secondary. And this one, RS485, this is a COM2, which is the FC bus. Connect to here. These are other terminals. Here, this is the power supply, and here is the ground. This is the internal some slot. Some slot connectors. Okay. Let's see the bottom side. This is the bottom side, bottom view here, the bottom here of the supervisory controller. See, this is a LAN 1, LAN 2. It's an Ethernet connector. Connector here. This one will connect to the computer or local network. And here, this is another option for the connection port, another port. And this is the FC bus connect to here. It's a COM2. So in the program, when we do the program, you remember here, this is a COM2, and this is the power supply, which is connect to here, and this is the ground. To access through the computer, to access the controller, to monitor the system operation, then you can input the IP address. This IP address is the supervisory controller IP address. So in the browser, you just input this IP address, then you can get into the interface, is the login interface of the controller. Okay. This is the FXPCV 1816 or 1832 programmable. controller. This controller is used to control the VMV box. Control the VMV box. VMV box, there is a damper. The controller is to control the damper. Let's see the components of the controller. The bottom part here, these four terminals is SA bus. These SA bus and they connect the IO module, input output module, for some the thermostat. Thermostat will connect to this port. This is a SB bus. Here, this is the FC bus. FC bus, which is here. This is a FC bus, and this is a SB bus. Between these two ports, there is a end-of-line switch. And here, this is a universal input, like the temperature, the pressure signal input. It's a universal input, the signal input to the controller here. And the top part here, these two terminals, is this one. It's a 24 volts power supply to the controller. And this one is a dip switch. Dip switch is used to set this controller, this controller address. And here, this is a binary output. Output the binary signal from here. And this is the configurable output. Can be binary, can be universal, or can be the analog signal output from these terminals. And these two, which is these two tube, here, these two connect to the airflow, the velocity pressure, airflow pressure, velocity of the air, connect to here, to sense the velocity pressure of the airflow. And here, this is a damper shaft to install here, and this is a set screw to hold the shaft of the damper. And in the middle here, this is a connector. This connector is a RJ45 connector. This is an 8-pin, which is connected connector here. This one, there is a Y connector, and connect to the Bluetooth can connect to here, the Y connector here, and then to make the communication between the controller and the computer. And here, some indicator, like the here, this one shows the power, and this is some port indicator, and SD bus, and the FC bus, end of line indicators. So you go ahead. For the controller installation, the wire connections are the same. Here is the FC bus here are connect to these terminals. This is the FC bus. The connections are the same. Positive to positive, negative to negative. Common to common. And then this is a shield. Shield wire connected here. For the SA bus, the same way. Positive to positive, negative to negative, common to common. And here's the power SA bus power wire here. These two terminals, just here, is the power supply to the controller, the hot and cold. This one. In the system, we use RTD, the temperature sensor, connect control to the system here. We can install the temperature sensor RTD to one of these terminal here. It's an input signal. This is installation about the PCB controller and PCG controller. This is a wire adapter. This jack, 8 pins, and this is a 6 pins. This is another 8 pins socket. The Bluetooth connector here. And then the computer and the controller can communicate each other through the terminal here. This is the installation of the PCB and PCG. This is a FX-PCG26 fuel controller. This is a fuel controller. PCG26 series, there are two models. 2611, 2621. These two controllers are same. The difference between these two is 2621. It has a screen to display some operation of the controllers. 2611, this PCG controller has no screen to display. This controller can use to control different equipment. For example, the pump, you can use the PCG controller to control the pump, the water pump. This is a programmable controller for general purpose. Programmable controller. It's a PCG. PCG, this is a fuel controller. Let's see this controller. Small. this controller, this is a PCG, 26 controller. The bottom side here, this is a, you can see here, this is an FC bus. FC bus, the cable connector, this is an FC bus, connect the field controllers. From one field controller connect to another one, or connect to supervisor controller. This is the terminal for FC bus. SA bus, this is a connect the sensors or input output modules. We can ask for the FC bus. Also, beside SA bus, there is another sensor port for RJ12, 16 connectors. Sensors like the thermostat, like the thermostat can connect to this port. And here, PCG, these at the bottom here, these are input, the signal input. This is a universal signal input, like the temperature, the pressure. These signals connect to the input here. This is a input one, input two, input three, and more here. So these are universal inputs. Here, this is a binary input. A binary input is on off. On off the signal, the connector here. On top over there, that's the output. Those are output. Like here, this is a output binary. It's also output signal. Binary signal here, connector here, and the here. Is a configurable and analog signal in connector. It's output output from this port. Right? These two terminals, this is the 24 volts power supply to the to this controller, which is here. It's a 24 volts. Power supply. This one, this is a dip switch to set the device, to set this controller address. Set this address. And here, these are some jumpers for different output. For this controller, PCG controller, this is a PCG 2621. There is a display here. This one, so this part here is a signal input. Here, this part is the universal input. And here is the binary input. And here is the binary output. Here is a configurable output and analog output. And here is some jumpers to set the output here. Set the output here for this side. And this one is the dip switch. This controller also there is a FC bus connector here. Also for this controller, the Bluetooth, the Bluetooth can connect to here to communicate, communicate there from the controller to the computer or from the computer to the controller. Through the Bluetooth, we can connect to here. And this is the display. Display. And this is some function buttons. Function buttons. So we can operate it to display the operation of this controller. And for the FC bus are the controller, the connection is in the same way, in the same way. Positive from one controller to another controller. A positive connect to positive. Negative connect to negative. Common connect to common. And the shield wire connect to shield wire. This is a FC bus. For the SA bus, SA bus do the same way. Positive to positive, negative to negative, common to common. And SA power wire is a connector power wire here. Right? So this is a connection the same way. This one here is the power supply to the controller, power supply for the controller here. For the signals, for the signal, in our system, we use RTD. RTD is a temperature sensor. In the lab, you use RTD temperature sensor. Some lab already. Right? So these temperature sensor will RTD will connect to the input to connect to input here. It's an input one connect to it. You can connect to other input terminals. You can connect to other input terminals. Here, also, this is a connector input, binary input, connector, dry contact binary input. Connect to field device. Dry contact. Some connectors also can connect to here. Some field device, the dry contact connect to input here. Can be connect to binary here. If here is closed, then an input a signal to the controller. So this one connect to the binary. And for the system here, this is the temperature sensor connector here, or the other field device connect to the other signal inputs. Then output some signals to control some equipment. Okay.